gonna watch this. Whoa. This is really, good.
Hey, Ren Day! What's going on, dude? It's like, I don't know, it's like 4:30 or some crap like that. I'm trying to text you a couple times, but I couldn't get a hold of you. But, I'm on my way over. I'm gonna pick up Chris, and we should be there probably about an hour. Couldn't really find anything on Netflix or anything. So hopefully, you are going to have to find something.
So, where's Randy at?
He should be around here somewhere. Let's go find him.
Randy!
Yo, Randy, where you at, man?
Randy!
Yo, Randy, man, are you in here?
Randy!
Dude, Pete, I can't find him anywhere.
Man, I don't know. He mentioned finding some sort of artsy film or something. Then you just dropped the phone. I don't know, I guess it was just really good.
A really good movie, huh? You know, it's just a rumor I've heard recently. More of an urban legend, really, but... Well, it's been causing a bit of a stir at the CIA. Thought you might want to hear about it.
Dude, what? Do you hear that? It sounds like a film soundtrack or something. Let's go check upstairs.
What story can you
read? I hope Randy's up here. I really want to drink a 40.
Yeah, man, I'm thirsty as a camel was and drank in many days. No!
What?
I'm just feeling a little bit uneasy about this, alright?
About what?
Haven't you heard the stories? The mysterious tape? Delivered or propagated throughout the United States?
I mean, I've heard stories about it. I don't really know any details. Can't be what Randy's watching. Probably just picked up a movie on his way home.
Don't you just find it at least slightly unsettling that Randy hasn't left that room in the last, what, like, 2 hours? I just think it's eerie is all.
Chris, you're the least superstitious person that I know. Seriously, what the hell?
I'm sorry, man, it's just this movie. The CIA have been searching for a master copy for years now. They say it's the last film from the great director, James Incandenza.
So? I love Incandenza's work. Blood Sisters 2 is one of my favorite movies. Dude, if he's in there watching his last one right now, dude, let's go. Let's go check it out.
Not Pete, you're not getting me, man. Like, this movie I'm talking about, at the time of its creation, it was the best movie ever made. Now, when they were working on it, it was officially titled Infinite Jest, but to those who know of it now, it's simply called The Entertainment. It was never released in theaters, but it's pretty much known as the director's greatest artistic achievement.
So wait, you're saying that you think that this Infinite Jest movie is what Randy has, and he's watching it in there? Dude, we gotta get him out of here.
No, dude, we can't go. Listen, we'd be caught in his field of view.
I don't care. Listen, we gotta get him out.
We'd be dead men. We'd be trapped forever. Even one glimpse of this movie might be enough to debilitate us for life. I don't know a lot about it, but my friend in the CIA, don't ask me how I have friends in the CIA, but he told me about an intern he knew who volunteered to view said film just as a preliminary test of its power. So 2 hours later, and the movie ended. The only way they could tell was from the horrible shrieking screams coming from the viewing room. The intern was still strapped to the chair, begging, play it again, rewind it, just one more scene, man. They did, but that's all he wanted. He refused to eat, sleep. He wouldn't even accept his insulin injection. He died 2 days later.
But if the movie's fatal, if that's even possible, why would they distribute it? Why would they even produce it to begin with? I mean, I just don't understand.
Well, you saw his movies, man. You know, Incandenza obviously had a few screws loose, right? He wasn't quite right, man. I mean, maybe the movie was just a mistake, a curse of his genius or something. He really was, you know, a master of the camera. And, like, as far as who would distribute that movie, it would only follow some kind of terrorist organizations hoping to use it as a weapon of mass distraction. You know, they realize us Americans never could resist a good film.
We're getting tired of waiting. Is there any way we could just go in there and get them without being sucked into the movie at all?
Well, there is one way. You'd have to have some kind of bandana and put it over your eyes. Go in the room and try to feel your way around for Randy and hopefully get him out of there without seeing the film yourself. Because if you get one look, it could be all over for us.
There's just... I don't have a bandana, though. Perfect.
The radio stopped tuning. The static is forbidden. The chords quit strumming. But we found our new home.
Dude, is he gonna be okay?
Can't even bear to look at him. Man's a lost cause. I don't think reality's ever gonna be enough for him.
Yeah. The movie must be, like, really good. I kinda wanna check it out.
Pete, are you insane? Do you see what it just did to Randy?
Yeah, I know, man, but I've never seen anyone that happy before. I kinda wanna try it.
I gave you a fair warning, man.
I'm just gonna
try. People in there are gonna be a fucking invalid just like him.
Let's see what it looks like.
Pete!